By the time I leave the school, it has really become pitch black outside. But instead of thinking about the fact that I'll be rather hit home today, I ponder about what Nao-san told me at the infirmary. Yeah, she told you to. She says she doesn't need you anymore. Go find love. Attentive to what's going on around me. Huh. Yeah, and that too. While thinking about the meaning of these words, I walk down the street in silence. And after a while, I've arrived at this place. What place? Oh. You again, Tina. You've been waiting for me all along on that tree. Tina? You came to pick me up today again? Well, thank you. Tadaima. Do you have to wait for me every day though? Sorry. I had some stuff to think about. Did you actually notice just now when Tina had those wings, her eyes weren't like purplish now, it's like they were like reddish earlier when she had the wings, yeah? Say Tina. I want to pick up where we left off yesterday. Will you hear me out? Why is it that I'm consulting Tina about it? Maybe because she's a spiritual being? I don't know. Or rather, what is it that I'm still mulling over at this point in the first place? So you have no intention of giving me some words of advice or something after hearing me out? Depends on what it's about, huh? Not like I'm gonna rely on you anyway, but if you want to listen, sure. That's a bit of a mean way to put it. Does my way of life look that awkward to you? How should I put it? Even though I actually should be feeling happy, I don't find myself satisfied. Well, because for you, it's just... you're just doing your job as a soul reaper, so... Basically, it seems I need to become even happier. Well, not really. Be truly happy. Not really even happier. And you call yourself a love fairy, Tina. It should have been. But I realized that it isn't. You know, the way we're talking to Tina is like we're talking to a kid. Yeah, you know, kid doesn't really understand much, so... But I guess there's some good in talking to a kid, so... This repeated exchange of question and answer now makes me want to tell her about that soul reaper I haven't spoken about with anyone until this moment. A long ago, I once died. Upon that, I received a new life from a soul reaper whose name I don't even know. Oh, he's revealing the truth now? Oh, Tina realizes something? Kotaro too? What that basically means is, this life that I have right now isn't just my own. That soul reaper also didn't tell me whose it is. To be precise, I lost consciousness before I got a chance to ask. I'm pretty sure it's that soul reaper's life. For that reason, I decided to live my life for everyone's sake with all I've got, so that I don't put this life and the one who granted it to me to shame. But? Yeah, basically that's what I've been saying for quite some episodes ago. That he's only caring about other people but not himself. Kind of like An from what I said in the previous episode. Me? I've been fine until now. That's because everyone's happiness is also my own happiness. Are you sure about that, Yuma? Are you sure? And there shouldn't have existed any inconsistencies in that. Up until now, that is. Up until she appears. Kind of. I mean Tina. But you know, it seems I wasn't the only one who has been thinking this way. Because of that, it seems that I have to become happy as well to truly make everyone else happy. Yeah, genuinely happy. Right. This is what I need to do. I ought to make myself and the life I've been entrusted with properly taste true happiness. I'm pretty sure you do, Tina. If you, well, if you can help me with that though. That life? As I really thought, I guess she really might know something about that Soul Reaper girl. But right now, there's something more important to talk about. So, after talking to various people, it seems that it all worked out somehow if I just smiled. Yeah, because I can't smile, maybe all the happiness is bottled up inside, since it doesn't have the natural outlet it needs. Yeah, you have to vent it out, well, in a happy way. Yeah, you cannot bottle it, no? If I think about it this way, I become a bit scared. Well, I guess it's because you never experienced it yourself, Tina. Sorry. What? Tina peers into my face anxiously. So you don't know that I was happy before? I wasn't aware of it, but that's how it is. I guess I'm not unhappy, but I'm not fully satisfied either. Until it was pointed out to me, it never even crossed my mind though. Okay. She murmurs something in the voice so low, I'm not able to make out more than half of it. I'm sure you don't. Totemo, okay. Like, okay. I think the English didn't translate that totemo. Totemo is, I really, really don't want that. That's what it means. Yeah, like extremely don't want that, something like that. I'm perplexed by the sorrowful gaze she directs at me. Why are you asking me? You're supposed to help me with that. But, well, in a way, this is pretty comical. That's because Tina has been pointing out the answer to that question from the very beginning. I think I only have to fall in love, don't you think? Yeah, I mean, you're the love fairy, Tina. What do you mean, eh? Didn't you yourself tell me that? That I would smile if I fell in love? Right, that's what she told me when I first met her. Did you already forget that, love fairy? Yeah, right. I guess it might be a good idea to fall in love. What do you mean? Eh? Staring at me in wonder, Tina freezes up. After all, there are also others who have recommended that to me. Surprisingly, it might not be so bad for me. Then slowly, Tina's face begins to form a proper expression again. Why do you look so surprised, Tina? Yeah, I did. Yeah, without you helping, thanks. Is this really something to cry over? What? So you say, unless I fall in love, you won't be a love fairy? But I thought you said you are a love fairy. Just when you think her eyes are wet, the next moment she's already happily smiling at you again. She changes her expression so fast, you never get tired from looking at her. You sure about that? Kotaro never... I never hear it from his mouth. Oh no, you're torturing Kotaro! Don't do that! Animal abuse! Don't wring his neck so much, that really makes me feel sorry for him. And all the more because of the fact that he looks like a plushie. Not yet decided. Look at Kotaro say, I think he said something about, don't strangle me so much or something like that. She casually flings Kotaro away and draws closer to me. Oh, okay. Like, she threw him away, alright. Right now, there's no one. Someday, maybe I'll find someone.
気が変わらないうちに今からしましょう。Tina,
that's easier said than done. There's no need to rush it. It's not something I can force. I have to naturally fall in love with a girl. I self-importantly announce what I've been told by Aoi-san and that bad-mannered nurse. Love is not something to be pressured, alright, Tina? So, give it time. It's not that easy, you know. Yeah, right, Tina. You're the one who's all talk and no action. You want to talk. She might actually have a point. If I just wait and do nothing, it probably won't change anything. Which means I should get myself more involved with other people, to the point that I can eventually fall in love with someone. But it takes courage to take that first step forward. Yeah? Hmm? Suddenly, she looks at me with a gentle gaze and smiles. Thank you. Well, if it's emotional mental support, I appreciate that. Even though you never helped me, it's okay. I think I finally understand what I've still been endlessly mulling over. Say, Tina, if I actually find a girl I love, at that time, how are you going to do that though, Tina? You have some magic power? I mean, as a love fairy, that is. In order to take that first step forward, okay. Most likely, I just wanted someone to give me a light push in the back. Okay, sure. We're on to the next day, April 18th, Thursday. The next day, I was in the middle of heading to a specific place. Oh? I think I probably understood it from the very beginning. If I started from here, things would start moving. But in order to do that, I would have to fix quite a lot of bad traits I still have. Like your smile, yes? And because I didn't want to confront that immature side of me, I kept refusing her invitations. Whose? Taking a deep breath, I steeled my resolve, believing that a bright future waits me beyond this door. Excuse me. And so I take the first step forward. What are those words I see behind you, An? You say something about love is banned? Most likely is banned because of the broken heart. But why? Why is love banned? What? Why? Just when Yuma wanted to fall in love, you suddenly say love is banned? What? Hey? But it seems this first step that I took with all my courage might have been a step in the completely wrong direction. So this first step that he took was to join the student council. But then, I don't know why Aunt suddenly introduced this rule. Okay, he hasn't actually joined yet. But now he saw the words love is banned. That's gonna make him even not gonna join the club even more. The student council. Right. Morning. Well, I see the words love is banned right there.
宿題を移したいなら残念だったな。
I don't give a damn about homework.
Koeta-kun,
Hoi, now you can make Yuri angry.
Yadana, Tsukishima-san. Sonna niramanai de hoshii in dakedo.
Watashi wa yatte kita yo.
Good for you, Mio.
Sasuga desu ne, Mio-san. Nage, nage.
Wow, Konami. Yeah, with you. But actually, no, never mind. I'm not going to join anymore. I throw a quick glance at the Love is Banned notice. It's not like my ultimate goal is to date someone. But still, it's true that I've begun to think that it might be a good idea. So now, confronted with the fact that this hope turned out to be the first step on the road to disappointment, I find myself at a loss as to how to react. Let's see. Alright, for now I should leave and come back again later after thinking this through one more time. It's nothing important. I'll come back later. Well, but it seems everyone is rather busy, so...
ユーリちゃん、今って忙しいの?今ので話が終わりみたいだし、あとは教室に戻るだけだけど。ね?だから用事がある人は連れてっちゃってもいいよ。それとも生徒会に入るつもりになった?
Yeah, until you wrote that those words. Well... Well, looks like you must put on the spot. Yuri? Even Yuri too? Despite that I haven't said anything yet, the conversation steadily progresses, as if I had already agreed to join. So, couldn't watch much longer, cuts into the conversation. Well, too bad, so I've been fired by her. Well, you're kind of on the right track. That's depending on Yuma whether he wants to reveal that. Now has already said you can, you know, you don't need to help me anymore. What should I do? Should I tell them about it? Might as well. You have a harem of girls right here. Even if I remain silent about it now, they'll eventually hear about it from her anyway. And it's not like there'll be a problem even if I just told them. About that, she dismissed me. All of them look at me with a surprised expression. Eh?
Kubi?
Yeah, Kubi, like dismissed, fired. Yeah, she said she didn't need my help anymore and told me never to come back. No idea to offend her or what, just that because I found a new purpose in life to find love, that's why she kicked me out. Shut up, so. As if. It's just that there were some reasons that led to it. She may always be teasing me for fun, but just like Aoi-san, she was always concerned about me one way or another. And that's precisely why she drove me out of the infirmary. She did what she thought was best for me. Well, yeah, I did say that, yes. Right. That's certainly what I said. Free. Yes, I'm free. Free from prison. That's how it is, yeah? I know what she's getting at. And I also know what I should do now. I guess I have no choice but to resolve myself, huh? Reconsidering won't get me anywhere. I came here because I've decided that I wanted to change. Just tell her that love is banned. Please take that down. Wait a moment, senpai. To begin with, only people who want to work for the sake of these school students should join the student council. That opinion still hasn't changed.
That's why I consider it to be wrong to join for a selfish reason like becoming able to smile. Yeah, so what reason is Yuma gonna give? Instead, I should work with the mindset and goal of bringing smiles to all of these school students. And if I become able to smile myself as a result of it, I think there couldn't possibly be any greater happiness. That's the kind of future I dream of. Please let me join the student council. For the sake of that future, I took my first step forward from here. I mean, so far the story kind of takes an interesting turn, but I just can't help but feel that it's kind of sudden. Like, maybe it's kind of sudden, like suddenly, just because of Aoi and Nao's words, you know, telling him that, yeah, because it all started with him not being able to smile properly, right? And then that's when Nao suggested to him that you should try finding love, you know? Maybe if you find love, you'll find true happiness, and then you'll be able to smile genuinely. And from there, that's when everything that he thought of, all his perspectives, you know, his mindset has started to change from here, you know? So I still feel it's kind of sudden, but it's an interesting change, yeah? So he's officially in the student council. Alright, I think we've already watched this, so I'm going to skip this. Yeah, in the very first episode we watched this before. So this is when the opening movie first came about. Okay. So that means everything before that opening movie we saw, that's kind of like the prologue or something like that. Now the actual route begins. Although I don't think we have reached the point where we are split into which girl we are going for yet. So, but anyway, and so I officially became a member of the student council. Not because of her, because of my Nao and Aoi basically. Just how many times are you going to bring that up? Put it to rest already. While throwing in appropriate replies to a topic I'm really tired of hearing right now, we walk in the hallway on our way to a different classroom. I guess, yeah. Yeah, apparently, she's gonna explain to me the student council's work. Well, that's because of your weird fetish. Isn't it just that she's being extra careful so that I don't quit? Now that the student council finally has an agreeable amount of members or number of members? I'm sure she did. Took a liking to me, you say. From my perspective, that would better apply to Konami and Mio. I can't tell you that. What do you want to hear? Isn't it a good enough reason that I was eventually swayed because she kept inviting me over and over again? Himitsu is a secret. Let me keep that to myself, yes. It'll be obviously be quite embarrassing to tell Sou about it. While we converse, Hanako approaches us from the front side. Yeah? Former, that is. Did he have to bring that up again now that I finally started to forget about it? What's the matter, Hanako? Just get it over with, Hanako. Well, I can really guess what she wants.
Asaba Yuma, anta seito kai ni haitta tte honto nano?
Yeah, I did. You got a problem with that? Something wrong with that?
Doushitemo koushitemo nai wa yo. Nande atashi ni damatteru no yo?
Why should I tell you? Why, you ask? Do I have an obligation to tell you?
Aru ni kimatteru desho, kiji ni suru ndakara.
So it's big news that I joined the student council, alright?
So in short, what she's basically saying is, she expects me to immediately leak juicy information to her. And as if that wasn't enough, she's saying that right to the face of the person who become the subject of that article. Lady killer? Me? I'm not happy about that at all. And you should first of all retort something in response to this girl's absurd logic. Student Council PR? Was it the newspaper club? I kind of figured it was something like that, yeah.
ほら、そういう関係もあるから、会長とも仲いいんだよ、月島姉さんは。
Oh, okay, partly because of that Pixie Tsukishima is also rather close to best. You mean Hanako, okay? Hanako is the big sis, right? Pixie Tsukishima? She's indeed Tsukishima's older sister. But that way of calling her feels off all the same. Well, because she doesn't want to be called Hanako, so... Now that you mention it, true? Indeed, there was an article about the union with the PMC. Sure, I will. I get your reasoning, but... Senpai is going to tell you anyway, right? I don't see a problem if you just waited for that. Well, yeah, that's true. Yeah, information speed is vital for journalism. Well, it's not like I don't know where you're coming from, but... Just when I'm about to object by telling her that I naturally can't take the risk of giving her inaccurate information, a powerful ally appears. Yuri? There you go, Yuri the heroine. Tsukishima? Most likely because we've been talking in the middle of the hallway, Tsukishima, who has exited the classroom later than us, suddenly joins our conversation. Wow, yeah, see, Yui, full support for me, eh? What do you mean, why should you care? I can punish you right here and now, you know? The two sisters glare at each other tensely. You aren't exactly in any position to say that in such a carefree manner, you know? You're also a PMC member. But it's not like you care anyway, so... So let me a hand. While exchanging looks, I move towards Tsukishima and also takes position next to Hanako.
Hanako-chan.
Oh, here we go, Hanako-chan! Wow, look at Hanako's reaction to so calling her Hanako-chan. Wow, look at so, yeah, praising Hanako, then now Hanako, oh, you call me beautiful, eh? Oh, I can't help it. Hanako immediately gets carried away by So's extremely poor flattery. Yeah, that's really poor, but somehow Hanako buys it. Jesus, how can you be so simple-minded, Hanako? Well, I guess I should accomplish my part as well. Tsukishima, I'm glad that you got angry for my sake, but you should calm down a bit. The PMC chairwoman shouldn't cause a scene in the middle of the hallway, right? Yeah. As to be expected of her, she's rational. Tsukishima, who agreed to my argument, loosens up again. Now you're gonna piss Yuri off, so.
よくわかってるじゃないの、あんた。単なる変態じゃなかったのね。あなこ。当然だろう。俺の目算によれば妹よりも若干太ってるのは間違いないからな。Oh no, so
that's it. You say it's unmistakably somewhat higher. You're so dead, so. You're so dead.
なんですって?
You're so dead. I know you have a fetish for chubby girls, but.
まあそれでもまだまだ足りないんだけどな。せめてあと 10 いや 5 キロだけでも。
Yeah, Hanako, you know that he has a fetish for chubby girls, right?
まずは二の腕を一回り大きくすることを理想にだな。 なんか怒って。
So you baka, you dumb guy. He's gonna get hit. Oh, he's down. So that was basically like stepping on a landmine. Even I know that much. Well, considering his fetish, I don't think he did. And what makes the whole thing all the more nasty? His estimation is actually correct. Yeah. Oh yeah, she's gone. Hanako traces her way back to where she came from while laying her anger bare by throwing complaints at us. Why did you add fuel to the fire? Yeah. Yeah, you did. But he's oblivious, obviously. Neither Tsukishima nor I rewarded his question with an answer. Okay, so after school?
Hi, dozo.
Shitsurei shimasu. Why is the love is bad for the banner still up there? Remove it, take it down. Just as promised this morning, bringing my lunch along, I showed up at the student council room. Okay. No, I'm not a guest, but a member now. Let me take care of the tea. Yeah, okay. But well, it's you. What am I supposed to say when she asked me that out of nowhere? You, right?
Well,
okay. Got it. I may be stubborn, but I think the same goes for her.
それじゃちょっと待っててね。
And so I guess that senpai is back for a while. Thank you, An. Thank you. I wonder if they're gonna explain what the tea is. And like maybe like Earl Grey tea or the finest tea, Dandel or whatever, Dandelion, whatever. After placing two teacups on the table, she sits down. Or probably not, it's just tea. Green tea? Oh, green tea. I love green tea. Well, yeah, true. I can agree with that, but green tea in a teacup, huh? Nothing wrong with that. I mean, yeah, nothing wrong with that. Well, I'm somewhat surprised due to that mismatch. Senpai begins to talk. Okay. Now that she's pointed it out, I realize it. It may have been in fact me who still felt like a guest rather than a member. You're right. Got it.
맞아, 고한 타베요까?
Just with the two of us? She takes out a plastic bag and spreads out the contents. You bought your lunch at the school store?
まあね。 おにぎりとかサンドイッチとか楽だよ。 書類読みながら食べられるし。
Yeah, that's convenient food, yes. That's bad manners.
少しぐらい許してよ。 ここだと誰も見てないしね。
Well, okay. Is it such a tough job to be the student council president that there is a need to go this far? Depends. Now that I think about it, I get the feeling she's always here whenever I drop by. It's hard to imagine from her usual demeanor, but I guess that's quite some pressure from work. Okay. Interesting. You mean her outfit? Japanese style. I don't know about well, maybe it's kind of Japanese style, yes. She herself seems to feel embarrassed wearing it, though. Well, at least in front of those she knows. I actually agree with her, but saying it out loud would probably result in her teasing me in various ways. So I ultimately keep it to myself. No, that would be too much of a burden for my mom, on top of her work. So I use the cafeteria or buy my lunch at the school store 2 or 3 days a week. Oh yes, that's yes. Oh, so she's okay, he said like 2 or 3 days a week, so the other 2 or 3 days will be to have will be home will be obento lah. Yeah, will be obento. You knew? Wait, oh yeah, that's right. Fair enough. I guess that's only natural then. In her position, she likely gets wind of special circumstances regarding students rather easily. Okay. I wasn't worried. I trust you.
So, yeah,
I think they know. I didn't really tell anyone. Mio obviously knows about it, but she wouldn't tell anyone either. And of course Konami knows. Is there something wrong with that?
役員の緊急連絡先どうしようかなって。自宅から通ってる子は 基本的に保護者だから。
Which would be, well, Asaba sensei, right? Or Mio or Aoi. I see. That's a fair reason. It should be fine to tell those two anyway, so I'll do so on the next opportunity.
はい、いただきます。
Right. Thanks for the tea.
はい、どうぞ。
And so I had lunch together with Senpai in a pleasantly calm atmosphere.
対応が必要なの。 わかった?
Okay, so we listen to the student council rules and all that. Yeah, no problem. I anticipated that our conversation would eventually digress completely, despite her saying that she would teach me about my job here. But in contrast to the expectation, she actually precisely explained everything to me.
大まかな流れはこんなとこかな? 質問はある?
No, I'm fine for now. I'll ask you if something, I don't know, comes up during the actual work. If that's okay with you.
Okay. 細かいことは小枝くんや優里の方が詳しいだろうから、そっちに聞いてもいいかも。
Okay. Got it. Thank you.
それじゃこれから頑張ってね。
Yeah, I will. In response to Senpai's words, I'm not feeling motivated. At any rate, it seems you really are the student council president after all. Well, normally you tease me. You're always the type to tease other people, so you don't look like a student council president. But yeah, I'm talking about the fact that you've just neatly explained everything to me in detail. Yeah, it was fairly easy to follow. Having said that, she displays an embarrassed smile on her face. Yeah, I forgot about the Shogi Club. Yeah, because the Shogi Club is part of the student council, so... Alright, I guess I'm a member of that as well now. Well, I don't mind. I play Shogi with Konami, so it's fine. No, Konami is there as well. I couldn't possibly mind it. So I guess that basically means you've really been doing club activities. Oh, you girls did? Is that so? I guess I haven't caught on to that because I've been coming home even later recently. If I had come home before her, I most likely would have become worried and asked her why she came home late. But all the Shogi Club does is play Shogi, right? Well, then I think there's really nothing to explain. Okay. I don't know when she managed to prepare it, but she suddenly places a shogi board on the table after saying that. Senpai, you want to challenge me? Okay, you're on. Ignoring my dumbfounded expression, Senpai proceeds to align the shogi pieces on the board enthusiastically. Okay, who won? I lost. Is I really that good at shogi, seriously? I instantly lost to her. I might have even set a new record with that playtime. I see you aren't the shogi club president for nothing. What? Why is it? What's the matter? Oh yeah, I think I know why Anne is so good. Because I'm kind of have a hint that she's not human. I mean, based on that scene we saw earlier when she's talking to a mysterious voice. Yeah? That's correct. I haven't lost a single time. I don't know. She always lost to me, or maybe it's because she adores me, that's why. Yeah, I agree. Like, you can say it's a jinx or something. Or rather, she has a soft spot for me. Yeah, I'm playing by instinct. So in terms of skill, it should be impossible for me to win against her. I once asked Konami why she couldn't win against me. Our late father was the one who taught Konami Shogi, and according to her, my playstyle is close to his. Bad at dealing with that playstyle, I guess. Yeah, she says it's so straightforward that it throws her pace off. So basically, the only ones I can win against are Konami, and people who don't know how to play Shogi at all. Well, I think she enjoys it though. If that's how she feels about it, I don't think she'll play with me in the first place. Yeah. That's why Konami probably... She genuinely loves Shogi because she was taught by our father. So she most likely only sees me as a wall for her to overcome someday. So please keep playing against her without holding back. Showing a bright smile, she nods. On that subject, there's something I would like to ask you. How come you're so good at Shogi? Did someone teach you? This is the question, yeah? Yeah, did someone teach you? Why are you so good at it, huh? Did you actually play cheat or something? yeah. Well, yeah. After all, I always thought that there shouldn't be many people Konami's age who are better than her.
So, Konatan is strong,
but Konami lost to you. So I wondered if there was some sort of secret behind your skill. You see, it's a secret. Yeah, she's definitely hiding something. I see. Long blood oozing effort. Well, I guess it's kind of true that if you continue to put in effort and never give up, that's where strength lies, right? Yeah? As she mutters that, a somewhat sorrowful and yet, in a way, nostalgic expression surfaces on her face. Sounds familiar. No, actually, I'm not. Maybe. Well, it definitely has something to do with her past, but. Right. Nothing just falls conveniently into one step. Until now, Senpai has simply put in more effort than Konami did. That's probably all there is to it, right? There's actually more than that. Incidentally, hasn't Konami won a single time against you yet? I mean, it's already been more than a week since she joined. Well, yeah. I can guarantee she would. Considering Konami's attitude towards Shogi, even I can't tell what punishment they will bring about. Better not do that. As a consequence, she might not speak to you for a while, you know. That's how serious she is about it. Yeah, please do so. I strongly believe that Konami will someday win against her. Give it your best, Konami. It's about her condition, right? You mean the activity to cure her constitution? Interpersonal countermeasures, was it? Well, I can see that it's quite extensive. How exactly? As I think about what she means by that, she gives an example of what her statement entails. Why are you suddenly asking about Koeta? Let's see. I'll say he's a joker with a chubby fetish. Outside? Outside? On the outside? You mean things like he'll likely be popular if he kept his mouth shut? That he'll be popular? Maybe. No, I just reiterated what I heard from other girls. Okay. Actually, now that I think about it, he might actually be rather handsome. Well, looking at him, yeah, kind of. He's a bit sloppy in his attire, so maybe if he can fix all that, fix his hair, then he can be handsome, yes? But maybe it's because his habitual image is just too strong in my mind. I just couldn't seem to see him in that light, regardless of what girls say. So, what about him? Yeah, you know, and that failed. You know, earlier, he was on the right track. He said that Hanako is a beauty, but then when his chubby fetish kicked in, yeah, but when he said he's heavy, Hanako is heavier than Yuri, that's it. Compliment? We should tell Ann about the Hanako incident. After hearing those words, I understood why So complimented Hanako earlier in that awfully wrong way. It's no good. He didn't get what Senpai told him at all. Yeah. Mio-chan's rehabili mo daiji da kedo, sekkaku da shi, kare mo naoshite agenaito. So you're saying I'll be the one in charge?
That makes sense. I hope you can do it. It'd be great if he at least stopped forcing his fetish onto girls the first time he meets them. What kind of rehabilitation are you doing, Mio?
男性に触れている状況のイメトレさせたり、目隠ししてユウマくんの真似した私と触れ合ったり。
I guess that kind of works. You pretend to be me?
ダメだった?
Well, I don't know how's that gonna work. I don't really mind as long as it helps Mio. But still, what in the world is she doing? And what's the result so far?
全然ダメ。
Yeah, BL content, I figured as much. I see. That's right, something also needs to be done about Mio's tendency to daydream. Sure. Yeah, of course. The matter itself isn't different from what we always do, but with another helper there might be some new development. I couldn't possibly be any happier if that happened. That PMC work, Yuri? Yeah?
Yuri,に聞いてね.
What? Yes? Okay, you don't know anything? Oh yeah, I can figure as much. But why is it that you told Yuri about that? That made her want to join the student council, you know? At least enlighten me on that. Huh? Well, yeah, I guess that's true. About the PMC, we should ask the person in charge herself, right? Well, I guess. Okay. I can't believe she would just shove everything onto Tsukishima after coming this far. No, I just thought that you're you after all. Well, if you want to take it that way, sure. It only means that my impression of you shifted back to what it was before. That's not really my intention, but it's true that I feel a bit disappointed, while at the same time, I also feel somewhat relieved. That is you. Another round of shogi? You mean shogi? I see you like it as well. Addicted to it? That's not good. Huh? After all the practice she must have been through, she became addicted to it? Okay. As you clear the board that has been left as is after my loss, and start to line up the pieces again, the chime rang. The chime rings. It seems so. Unfortunately, we have to postpone our rematch. Alright, you're gonna stay here? Sure. Alright. Would it be alright if I was a bit late? Yeah, I have a little something I need to talk about at the infirmary. Well, just to consult on some things. No, I'm not. I mean, I wouldn't do something so half-assed after saying I would join. Well, to thank her? Alright, see ya. While being seen off by Senpai's smile, I leave the student council room. Alright.